how do you learn SAP integration? So a recurring question that I often get is this: how do we actually learn all of these different tools? What is important to learn? And how do we actually get to do these things? So SAP integration seems to be a really hot topic, and I've also covered that in quite a few blogs and videos, that there's a really a large focus about making sure that integration works. And I think there was this Gartner survey that said that 50% of development costs would be integration in 2020. And at least I see there's a lot of integration going on. And obviously, yes, working in it, it matters. So in the SAP ecosystem, there is the cloud integration tools. And I think there's four different products that make sense that you learn and there's a request for. So the first is process orchestration, process integration, which is SAP's big integration product that has been out on the market for like 13, 15 years, as a tool that really is robust and is handling a lot of integrations. It's not being developed as much as it used to be, but it's still robust and it will also get an update in 2020, something like that, where there will be adding a little more enhancement to what's going on in it. But it is a core fundamental of a lot of organizations integration, and therefore I believe that it will be there for a lot of time, because it works and pretty stable, really stable, and that is what you need for an integration product. The other one that I see demand on the PI, there's some projects going on right now. That's the migration from the dual stack to the single stack, from the B2B from cBurger to B2B add-on, and there's just normal integration products. Projects going on. We need this new development going on, and that will continue. Then one of the new tool is the cloud integration, or maybe it's like 5 years old, is the SAP Cloud Platform Integration, which is a little more flexible, a lot more flexible, and have some good use cases in the cloud integration world where you cannot just say we just deliver a message and then everything will be good, but where you actually just need to make query pulling on services that you cannot control. So I've seen quite a lot of requests recently coming on that platform, and this is especially true if you're working with any of the other SAP product, because then for some of them, like SuccessFactors, you are getting a CPI tenant and you can do some of the development on that one. I've also seen a little on the API management. API management is a way that you can expose backend data in a secure way to the internet and give users a better understanding expose backend APIs in a secure, scalable fashion that will not break the existing infrastructure that you have. And then the other one that could be interesting, I haven't seen many requests on it yet, but obviously it's also pretty new, is the SAP Open Connectors. That is a little more generic generic framework for connecting with applications, and it is really simple and setting up connections to a lot of different providers, because they're just using the same approach. So that is something that I see coming in the short term also. Then how do you actually learn integration? Because it's not something that you go out and just read a book on. Like the cloud platform, SAP HANA cloud integration, there should be a new edition coming out now that I'm looking forward to see what contains. But there's there's different parts in the learning journey that you have. So I think the first part is understanding what's going on. So this would be either reading a book with some exercises and do SAP standard training, or do attend video training online like my picourse.com, where you can actually learn a lot about the at least the PI tools and how they work, what's in it, and all the different benefits of working on that platform. So that is really a simple way of getting to do or at least the initial part about how do we actually get to do these things. Next step and is then to get hands on and figure out how do we actually work with these tools. So on the PI, there's in the cloud platform application library, cal.sap.com, there's a PI system you can start up and run to learn how you can actually use that one on your own with getting real hands-on on it. For the CPI, there's currently not a trial version that you can try out, so you need either to have a trial or a system from your organization. You can sign up for the trial program and get a 30-day trial access. I'm not sure what the status is of that one, but let's see what's going on in that space. And then for the API management and Open Connectors, there's a full functioning trial that you can just start using, and that makes it a lot easier to get your hands on and figure out how it actually works. So that was the hands-on and just setting up a scenario. But still, the place where you're really learning is the part about doing real integration work, where someone comes, hand you a specification, say, this is what I want. Can you build it for me? And you would have to go through and figure out, so how does this actually work? What is it? And how do I translate this into a real world scenario? And no matter which training you have taken, there will always be places where you say, okay, we got from this part, and then how do we actually make sure that it works for the scenario that you have? And this is where you need to do the real thinking and figure out what you need to do in this case. So when I started, I had a mentor that had a little more experience with SAP integration than I had, and knew the tool. So I was doing some of these things, figuring out how it worked. Then I would call him and say, okay, I got this problem. How do I go around it? And then I got some feedback, could try to implement this. Go back and say, okay, this worked, this did not work, and this was actually what was going on. So this part of having a mentor in your organization or externally or whatever is really a crucial step in the learning process about giving and understanding what have you done for the scenario. And a lot of time when I'm out recommending people to do new integration and figure out how to use the tool, I would say, well, the best way to learn it is to do a scenario, get some feedback on it, figure out does this really work or not, and maybe even in the process also have some feedback sessions, saying, okay, I want this scenario, how would you propose that we create this this scenario? So that is one of the key things about learning and taking your skills to the next level, having some kind of a mentor working with you on these things. But yeah, then if you don't have that access, it's just about creating a lot of scenarios, figure out how it works, figure out, take them all the way to production, and then see, does this really work? Did it scale in the way we wanted to? Or was this just something that was fun to make? So I hope that this have made a lot of sense to you, that there's a lot of tools out there for the SAP integration, and there's obviously a lot more tools that make sense, Gateway, and a lot of the other tools in the cloud platform integration suite, cloud integration suite, that you can actually use and start implementing. So in the text below the video, I've tried to put on some of the links that I've seen would be interesting, but otherwise it's going through a lot of the blogs on the topics and figure out how does this fit in. But there's definitely still room to learn a lot about SAP integration, and as I see it, you would still be able to get a job in that area. So yes, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give me a like. I really appreciate that. Otherwise, have a good learning journey and get to learn some of these tools. Oh, one thing just before I end up. So there is the opensap.com. There's a lot of good trainings on there that also would be of interest to you on some of these tools, so you can understand what they're actually doing. So check also that place out. So thanks for watching. Talk to you later. Bye.